Warning, adventure activities can be extremely dangerous. Please use extreme caution when out in the elements, and if you should, go ask your mom. Now, go out in it!
Now,
look at the grasslands.
I'm gonna do better than that. I'm gonna go through them.
We are breaking down the third wall today. Welcome. John, you want to break down the third wall today?
I'll do that.
So, what's the journey today, James?
We're in Agua Fria.
Where are we going?
We're looking for the Squaw Creek ruins, I think, and the Brooklyn group.
Wow.
At least that's the coordinates I looked up, so I hope that's what you guys were hoping to see.
Ruins!
Ruins in general, though, that is the goal.
The problem with the coordinates is I put them in.
Oh, we're... Dude! Jay Shrek!
And James!
And John somewhere.
Where'd John go? Oh, we always lose John.
This is a highlight, right? This is a highlight right here. This is a place that is one of the most incredible ruins that we're probably going to do. It had an exterior wall that was 800 feet around that we haven't seen the like of this anywhere. So let's go take a look at this. Automatically, when we come out of here, pottery and obsidian everywhere. I mean, this place is just incredible. Well, you do realize how important Black Mesa was after you see it, you know? You realize that is probably the best wall we're ever gonna see. You know, that wall was unbelievable. These walls right here are pristine. Oh, look at, oh man, this whole point is just beautiful. This is one of the most beautiful places. It just never ceases to absolutely amaze me what's here available in the Arizona desert. It just is spectacular. This is one of the most beautiful places. And the peacefulness and the, you know, how cool is this? The beautiful walls up there still intact. You know, this is an incredible place. I mean, what do you guys think of this? I mean, this is pretty spectacular. You know, if you look over here and you see that wall that goes all the way across, and you can also see petroglyphs on that wall. So they hung off that cliff right there. And then I was just looking right here, and look down there, there's a deer, another petroglyph out there. So John's already down there shooting. So we're gonna come in through here. You can either walk around or walk through and then back. Either way, it's the same distance, so it really doesn't matter which way we go or how we go. What do you think about the ancients that used to live here? What kind of life do you think they had? What do you think about that? You know, it's kind of fun to get to do this and come along with me as we kind of see, you know, over here. Now, around this perimeter over here, one of the cool things was they had a wall. Okay, the Great Wall is what I call it, because you don't see walls of this size. They say 800 feet. Now, if you see that wall right here, all the way through here, it goes all the way out and around, and then the ruins are here. But they also had a wall up here on this cliffside so their enemies couldn't come in and get them. And then, I mean, this is unbelievable. And everywhere you look, it's pottery shards, obsidian, you know, all kinds of stuff like that. James is out there right now taking a look at all that. But it really is just a fascinating place that you get to come and see. You know, when you look at this wall, and there's pieces of this wall that are still up, I can just imagine what kind of an intimidating place, you know, it would have been at one time. You know, and I'm not sure it was, you know, one story, two stories. Most of these were two or three stories. Most of them were. They weren't just one. But I'm not sure of this one, but it's a nice wall right in there. Look at that. That is just beautiful. That is beautiful. This would have been a pretty cool life, wouldn't it? I mean, if you think about this. But what a beautiful place to live. Gorgeous. Look at those flowers. Hey, James, let's go. You know, we might as well just drop in now. Either way, we got to walk around and then down. There's another bird. Do you see those two falcons up there?
Flying around.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't have the right camera.
This is old stuff. There's kind of a neat circle. Right here. Which is the painted deer. That's what we're after. Painted deer. What a beautiful place. You know, one thing about Arizona is that the beauty of Arizona is unbelievable. I mean, you get where you're in desert and then you're in mountain and you're in pine. I mean, you're everywhere. What a beautiful place this is. Be able to see this. Some stuff up there. I do not see the deer yet. What do you think that it means? What do you think any of this stuff? Now let's take a look at this right up here, for example. You know, what's your thought process on any of this right here? So get up this hill. This is how this stuff is laying around. Look at here. Big piece of pottery right there. So I'll get up here. So you see this a lot, the dots, right? Could be days, maybe the amount of antelope, deer, you know, who knows? But what do you guys, what do you think all this means? You know, was it a form of entertainment? You know, a lot of people say that a lot of treaties, you know, because, you know, they didn't get along back then as well as we don't get along today. Ain't nothing changed with humans. You know, we got James, you know, we're looking for this deer. James is right down there. He's running that lower ledge to see if it's on the backside of one of these rocks. You know, we've seen pictures of it. We're walking this ledge up top. You know, there's a couple ledges it could be on. It could be on the southern ledge. We don't see it from up here, but it was very distinct. It was very distinct when we saw it. It was not, you know, something that you wouldn't be able to see. I mean, it really stood out, probably better than most of these here. Now that's a pretty good size wall right there. How nice is that? Maybe you can get in here without getting on the wall. You know, the last thing you want to do is climb on these walls. They ain't gonna last very long if you do. So look at that wall there, it's still fairly intact. You know, and again, when you see these here, that means that pot hunters got a hold of them and dug them. You know, there's no doubt in my mind as I carefully make my way over here. Got a good strong wind too, which makes it always a little more fun to do this kind of stuff. So you get out on this ledge, you get over here and you look down in there. You're looking over here and you're going, okay, it's only been here millions of years, but get up on here and you take a look and you look out here, you look out and you go, you know, you look out here and you just go, man, you know, I know I'm not the first guy to set on this rock. I'm not gonna be the last either, but you know, you think about it when you look over here and you look at that wall. You see it over there. You see the walls coming off. So this structure was massive. This is a massive structure with massive walls around it. It had to have been a pretty intimidating place, you know, at one time to see, because it would have been pretty ominous. And you look down there, you see that little guy right down there, you see deers right down there, see a bunch of deers down there. We're gonna get down there. I wanted to see if we couldn't find the deer though, over here. But what a great place to sit and take a look. See over my head, see what I get to look at. Then see what it looks like over there. How cool is this? You know, not everybody gets to do this, and I definitely understand and appreciate the fact that I do get to do this, and what a neat life this is. And I'm glad you got to come along with me. Not everybody gets to do this, and I understand some people physically can't do it, and I'm just happy that I could take you along, and I'm just happy that I can still do it myself and still come out to these places in Arizona. Arizona's the most beautiful state. You know, not that there are in other great states, but I'm telling you, Arizona is just beautiful. So what we're gonna try to do is work our way down here and see, you know, I'm thinking maybe could be over there, okay? That could be, the deer could be on that ridge right there. A lot of times they like to put important structure stuff right there. You know, there's some stuff over here, but it's not that red deer we're looking at. So as we make our way from over here, over there and down there, we cross over here, we get over here, take a look, see what's over there, and we take a look and we try to find this deer. So James is gonna work that line there. So who you got your money on? Who's the big money gonna be on? It's gonna be on me, it's gonna be on James, it's gonna be on John. John's got a weird way, a stealth way, you know? He's got that old stealth guy's way of like stumbling into this stuff, you know, when we're maybe running across. He's maybe watching a little better, and he seems to come up with the last two petroglyphs that we were searching for. He actually found them. So yeah, I think we'll go around that tree. I don't think there's any reason to hang out on the cliff. I don't see a lot of work down here. I just don't. We're getting down on this edge, and I don't know really what, you know, what's out here. Okay, when you're doing this stuff, this is what I call an oh shit rock right here. Hear that? Look at this thing. Look how big it is. When you come across a rock and you're out there, and that happens, even though at this time it ain't gonna, you know, it's not gonna fall. But I tell you what, you almost gotta go change your shorts. And I don't have another pair of shorts to change into. So, you know, we got some good, cool petroglyphs right there, it looks like. You could come right, it looks like your best bet's right through here. Might want to just start bouldering straight over, right? See, right? If you go straight.
Yeah, I'm trying to get over this.
Well, James just said, as he's working back, he just said he found the deer. So we got to get over there without killing ourselves. Find out where he's at. Can you see, is it facing that way? Well, now we gotta see. You can't give up. You can't give up ever. You gotta keep searching high and low, because I would have, you know, he walked by it, he went down by it. So this goes to show you, can't quit. Would you quit? Nah, you're with us. You can't quit when you're with us. You gotta stay. Well, I'm gonna get down here, take a look and see if that's anything I wanna attempt to go down. Could I get out? That might be the biggest thing. Could I get out? Yeah, we definitely don't want to take a header off this bastard. That's for sure. So you watch me if I crash and burn, you're gonna be good. So, first part's done. Now, what we're gonna do is make sure there's no oh shit rocks here. And then we come down here, and I don't know if I can get down here. So I'm looking at James right here. I think this was the trap door, man. Oh, looky there. There that bastard is. Damn, I don't know how you get up to me, though.
Yeah, I don't know either.
How do you get up to me?
Oh, I think I'm going to have to go back down this little sketchy ass path.
Okay, John got up here, okay? Up that. And he better be goddamn careful when he gets down here, or he's gonna get his ass kicked. But do you get it? Is it good enough shot, I mean, in this area?
The thing is, yes, because I put my new camera on this for an experiment, and this new camera's like 35 megapixel.
I was hearing a bird.
So it,
just, hey, grab that camera from me, would you? Just so he doesn't have to, he's got both hands, just drop mine somewhere.
Pictures?
Yeah, so once you get stuck,
all right. Okay, here we are. We're gonna climb up, see what we got to deal with right now. James already has been up and down. We're gonna try to get back up here with this camera, take you guys down, and then we'll show you what we got at the same time. We're climbing up through here. Okay, you guys ready? This is gonna be, look at that. How cool is that? So we didn't give up, man. We kept going. Look up there, how cool is that? Man, look at this deer right here. Isn't that sweet? That is sweet. This is one of them once in a lifetime deers. Look at that down there. Wow. What do you think, James?
I'm glad we kept pushing for it. That was a fun climb, too.
It was a fun climb. See, that's what we got down there. You know, oh, we got an oh shit rock right here. Oh shit. Yeah, up here, especially. Okay. See, now we gotta go down that canyon right there. So I'm gonna give this to James, and then you guys can watch me bust my ass coming down here. Cause it's on right now, and James will shoot it. He'll shoot it coming down. So one right there. Gonna rock that one there. I'm not sure exactly what's the.
I kind of did it like through intuition.
What tells me to go there?
I think I held on up there and got my foot to here.
I got a good rock here. That was not as easy as I thought it was gonna be.
Yeah.
Damn!
Yeah, that's no fucking job.
Well, we didn't quit, man.
No, that was good, man.
We didn't quit.
That's good.
We kept on the gas. And John got through the hardest part, which is this right here, this loose shit. So he made it through there. Awesome, James. Okay, we found it.
We found it. Pretty cool ruins too.
And James found it. So whoever bet on James over me or John, because I had a little thing going, James.
Oh, did you have a?
Yeah, that was. And I told him, I said, John usually somehow old man gets this shit, but James is a winner. That means he buys pie.
Oh,
yeah, you.
You keep changing the rules on who gets pie.
As we should.
As we should.
As we should.
There's always balance in one person's favor. Just gonna throw that out to you.
Well,
warning, adventure activities can be extremely dangerous. Please use extreme caution when out in the elements, and if you should, go ask your mom. Now, go out and in.